We're settling into the first decades of the 21st century, and racism is still a part of our culture. Despite the steep modernization of football, racism still lingers in stadiums across Europe.
So it is with great pride that we are out here in Munich, digging up the forgotten Jewish history of Germany's biggest club, especially one man's instrumental act of defiance.
Bayern Munich were not always the biggest club in Germany. They won nothing in the early 1900s. But in 1932, a former player turned president, Kurt Landauer, led Bayern to its first national championship. A year later, however, the club was nearly destroyed.
We had a Jewish president, we had a Jewish manager, and we had a Jewish head of the youth department, and those were the fathers of this success. And one year later, 1933, the National Socialists claimed the power here in Germany, and all of those guys and Kurt Landauer had to leave the club. He wasn't allowed to be part of the club. He had to go to the concentration camp.
He didn't have any privileges in camp at all. There was now an exchange of letters with his later wife. In that letter says, I'm not going back to concentration camp. I'd rather kill myself.
But he was able to leave the concentration camp and immigrated then, refugee to the Switzerland, and stayed there the whole Second World War.
He was one of the first to be released, but not because of his connection with football, because he was somebody who fought in the line in World War I. That time was a condition for Jews to get a little bit of a better situation.
Why do you think Kurt returned to Munich?
I suppose he wanted to find his roots again, which was football.
Kurt didn't see himself as a Jewish person. He saw himself as a Munich football fan and as the president of FC Bayern. He was very ambitious. He always his big dream was to win the German championship, and he received it. He had a lot of other plans and visionary plans for the club, for the football in Germany.
And he actually right away went to the American occupation officer, tried to get a license for football clubs, but Americans wouldn't allow it because they thought that the sport clubs were the root of Nazism. And Kurt came and explained to him patiently that it didn't apply to the Bayern, and he got him the license.
So what impact has Kurt's legacy left on the club?
This visionary mindset and also the family mindset, because when you are different and when you have a lot of enemies, when you are the Jewish club and everybody is critical with you, you stay together and you are strong together as a family. And that's also one thing I think he left in Bayern Munich and in our club, and is still existing today.
Landauer passed away in 1961, so he didn't get a chance to see the club he helped build go on to become domestic and European champions so many times over. But when his legacy at Bayern was unearthed, his club supporters made certain that anti-fascism would be a part of the most storied club in Germany's identity.